YouTube, welcome back to another one of my videos. So if you guys have been watching the channel for a while, you guys may have noticed, if you've been watching for a long time, you're really gonna notice this. I haven't changed the channel art or the graphics or anything for this channel in about 3 years. I kind of changed it slightly in 2018 instead of the banner saying new videos every Friday and Saturday, I changed it to new videos every week. And that's the only real change I made, but the actual artwork itself was the same, it was just the text that was different. So this year I decided, now that I have some time on my hands and I actually know how to use Photoshop, that I would make my own channel art. I was originally going to commission an artist to do it, but then I thought, you know what, I'll put my own skills to use. So to do this I used Photoshop and After Effects. I have very, very basic knowledge of Photoshop, and I learned After Effects as part of my university course this year, so I'm quite proficient now in After Effects, but for this I just done some basic editing in it. So if you guys watched the channel and then you also like went on to like my channel page, you will notice that the banner is the same as the end card, and I really like that because it just makes everything on the channel match and it be the same. So I wanted to do that again, but instead of just having at the end of my videos that kind of dip when I do the thumbs up and that dips to white, and I will put a dip to black at the very end and that just closes out the whole thing. So I've always done that with my videos, and I do that with the image, the main channel art image. For this, because YouTube has since, from when I made the banner initially, YouTube has changed the way that end cards work. They got rid of annotations and now they have these end cards that you can import and use for your channels. So basically what I've been doing for the past, like since they implemented that feature, is I just imported it from a video and it covers over my art. So I didn't want that to happen with this one. I'm going to show you guys the banner that I'm going to be using, and then I'm going to show you guys the end card, and then I'm going to end the video and also use the new channel artwork, because when this video goes live I'll be using the new branding. So what you're seeing now is the brand new channel branding made by me. I always like my designs to be quite simple. I don't like anything too flashy, and I just wanted also something that would stand out. So what I done was I put a drop shadow and a kind of glow around the Stevie L to make it kind of pop out. It looks a bit more 3D. And then I just put in, you know, the three things that I do in my channel. And I was trying to think on like, how can I sum it up in one line? And then I thought I'll just list the things that I do here in the channel, which is game collecting, LGBT stuff, and vlogging. And then I decided to represent the LGBT with the pride flag. And I also put a DualShock 2, well, like a kind of clip arty DualShock 2 on the side there, just because like that is my favorite console of all time, is the PlayStation 2. So I want to symbolize that by putting it on my banner. Obviously the banner has its kind of pink. It's not a solid pink, it's a pink gradient, and then I just turned the opacity down. I think it looks pretty good. Pink is my favorite color, so that's why I wanted to put that in there. And here is the file that I made in After Effects. So for the end card, I wanted to keep the transition the way that I've had it, you know, since I started doing that. I really like how I end my videos and I want to keep ending them the same way, but obviously integrate this new channel art. So what I done was I made it just the banner for like the first little bit, and then it'll push up, and then the subscribe and the end card can come in, so then you can click on those and that, you know. It's very simple After Effects. I just keep put it in the Photoshop frame and then keyframed and add in that little bit of text. Another thing is that my profile picture that I have for this channel, that photo is of me when I'm 17, so I need to update it, so I will be updating that. I was gonna make like a little channel avatar, but I think it's more personal if I have my face. But yeah, I think that is everything I have to tell you guys about the new branding. I'm really happy with what I made. I think it does kind of sum up the channel very well. I think it is a better representation of the channel now than my current banner, and especially when I get that avatar changed out, the channel will look a lot better. Thank you guys so much for listening to me nerd out about making and editing things. If you did enjoy it, please give a big thumbs up and also subscribe, much love, and hopefully I will see you guys in the next video. And now you get to see the new outro in action. So thank you guys so much for watching. And hopefully I will see you guys in the next video.